Hi everyone, Miss Gab here. Today we're going to be making some crayons at home. We're going to recycle and reuse old crayons and make them into new crayons. Let's get with it. For this activity, we're going to need some crayon molds and some old crayons, super easy. Then we're going to peel our crayons. We're going to take the paper off. I used this slicing method with knife, but if you use this method, be sure to do it under parental or adult supervision so that you don't cut yourself and end up bleeding. And once your crayons are peeled, it's time to get creative. The first color that our crayon that I designed was this like green with white and blue. Then I went with some oranges and reds and dark colors. Then I did some more greens and more blues, but in a different tone. And then I did this earthy crayon. And then I stuffed my extra crayons into my extra mold. You guys only have one mold, so if you have extra crayons, you may have to repeat the process once or twice. I like the idea of coming up with my own colors, but also having rainbow colors like the ones in this mold is pretty cool too. Once you are happy with your color combination, you're going to want to put them in the oven with a cookie tin on top of a cookie tin at 250 degrees for 10 to 15 minutes. If you open the oven and you see that your colors are not melting, you can up the temperature to 300 degrees and put them in for 5 to 7 minutes at the end so that they melt well. As you can see, my colors did spill over, but I'm glad I had them on top of the cookie tin so that I didn't get the mush all over my oven. I will, next time I do this, I will wrap my cookie tin in aluminum foil for an easy cleanup because this took a little too long for me to clean afterwards. Once you take this out of the oven, let them cool for 30 minutes to 1 hour so that they are solid and don't break when you demold. Once your crayons are solid to the touch, you can demold. And this is the most satisfying part of it all. Getting the crayons out of the mold is so satisfying. You can hear the crack of the mold. You can see the swirls and the bonds. It's so, so, so cool. Moment of truth. This is me testing out the colors that I made. This is the orange one, then the green and yellow swirl. I like this pink to dark blue. The earthy color that I made doesn't really show up that great on paper. And this is a black and white one. I think it would look great on black paper. And here are some other color combinations that I did. And here are the final swatches. Thank you for joining me. I can't wait to see the color combinations that you come up with, and I hope you think this activity was as cool as I did because I loved it. Anyway, I'll see you next time. Bye!